Welcome everyone in our third lecture. The first lecture covered the meaning of science. The second lecture was what is chemistry. And now our third lecture that is about matter. Now what is matter basically and how we can classify the matter? Actually, matter is anything which has mass and occupies space. So what is matter? Anything which has mass or weight and it occupies space, that is called as matter. In chemistry, there is no difference between mass and weight. So you can replace the word mass with weight. Basically, matter is the stuff of the universe. Matter is the stuff of universe. I mean, matter is the stuff from which the whole universe is made. Now, matter can be classified broadly into two main classes. One of them is pure substances. The first class of the matter is the pure substances. And the second class is mixtures. Matter is broadly speaking classified into two types. One of them is the pure substances and the second of them is the mixtures. Now, what is a pure substance? A pure substance is the one having constant physical and chemical properties. Pure substance is the form of matter having constant physical and chemical properties. Now, second feature of the pure substance is that it cannot be separated into other substances by using physical and chemical methods. A pure substance is the form of matter that has constant physical and chemical properties throughout. And if you want to separate them into other substances, you cannot do it. means a pure substance cannot be separated into other substances. Now what is mixer? Mixers have varying physical and chemical properties. Mixers have variable physical and chemical properties. Just like you can say that if you mix ethanol and water, its boiling point may be in a range depending upon the composition. So mixers have variable physical and chemical properties. Secondly, they can be separated into other substances by physical methods. So mixer can be separated into other substances. And what are those other substances? Basically, a mixer is a combination of the pure substances. When the pure substances are combined physically, there must not be any chemical contact between them. Then the mixers are produced. So when we say the other substances, actually these other substances are those pure substances from which the mixers are made. So they can be separated, they cannot be separated, they have variable physical and chemical properties, and they have fixed physical and chemical properties. These are the two major differentiating points between them. Now pure substance is further classified into two categories. One of them are elements, and the second one are compounds. Now what are elements? Elements are that form of the pure substance that have atoms with same proton number. In any element, the atoms are having the same proton number, mean they are having the same atomic number. And now even the element cannot be separated, cannot be separated into its constituents by the chemical means. Examples of the elements, there are so many, like 118 elements of periodic table. So 118 elements are there which have been discovered so far in the periodic table. Two points are there to keep in mind. Number one, the elements consist of atoms with the same atomic number. And number two, the elements cannot be separated into their constituents by simple chemical means. What is a compound? When two or more different elements combine in a fixed ratio by mass. When two or more than two elements, their atoms combine in a fixed ratio by mass, then we get the compounds. And there is large variety of the compounds. There are so many examples of the compounds, like you can say water, salt, etc. These are the examples of the compounds. Now mixers, the general features of the mixers have already been discussed. But the mixers are again divided into two categories. These two categories are of mixers. What are these two categories? Homogeneous mixers and heterogeneous mixers. So mixers are further divided into the two categories, homogeneous mixers and the heterogeneous mixers. What are homogeneous mixers? Homogeneous mixers are those that have fixed composition and uniform properties. Homogeneous mixers are those in which there is fixed composition and the uniform properties throughout. I am going to explain it, but first of all I will give the example of the homogeneous mixer. For example, sugar plus water. So when you thoroughly mix the sugar in water, that is an example of the homogeneous mixer. If I give you a simple example, it is the sweetness. You cannot say that the solution on the upper side is less sweet and the solution at the bottom is sweeter than that of the upper part. The sweetness is same throughout. So in this way, the properties are homogeneous throughout. These are the uniform throughout. These are the homogeneous mixers. Now what's about the heterogeneous mixers? Obviously, fixed composition? No. Uniform properties? No. They do not have fixed composition and uniform properties throughout. There are so many examples of the heterogeneous mixers in the daily life. Like you can say rocks are example of the heterogeneous mixer. One of the very interesting example is the pizza. Pizza is also an example of the heterogeneous mixer. That's why we keep on fighting that this side is mine, this side is yours. Especially the people who love chicken pieces, they will like to take that side of the pizza having more chicken pieces. If the chicken pieces were distributed uniformly, the fight is over. So pizza is an example of the heterogeneous mixer. Now the heterogeneous mixers are further divided into the two types. One are the colloids, other are the suspensions. You must have an idea that the homogeneous mixers are also called as the true solutions. So homogeneous mixers are also called as the true solutions. And the further types of the heterogeneous mixers are the colloids and the suspensions. What are colloids? What are suspensions? Inshallah, we will discuss them in the upcoming lectures at the right time. But a slight difference I would like to mention here, that is in case of true solution, the particle size of the solute that ranges from 0.12 1 nanometer. The particle size of the solute ranges from 0.1 to 1 nanometer. Why I'm telling you all this here? Just because sometimes the MCQs are asked. And in case of collides, 1 to 1000 nanometer. Sometimes it is also written 1 to 10 raised to power 3 nanometer, so that is same. And suspension greater than 1000 nanometer. These are actually the particle size. In case of the true solution, we call that phase solute. In case of the collides and suspension, some different names are given to them. That will be discussed in detail in some next lectures. So this is a brief summary of the chemical classification of the matter. Otherwise, the matter can also be classified on the basis of the physical states. And there are so many other ways. But this is the chemical classification of the matter. Different MCQs can be asked from this topic, like pure substance, in case of pure substance, in case of elements, compounds, etc. For example, water. Oil, air, oxygen. Now these are the four options. The question is, which of the following is a compound? Which of the following is a compound? No, compound is a pure substance. You can see that the pure substances here, these are two, water and oxygen. Oil and air, everyone knows that these are the mixers. So these cannot be the pure substance. The question is, which of the following is a compound? So water and oxygen. Water has formula H2O. And oxygen has formula O2. The oxygen is made up of two same atoms having same atomic number. So that will belong to the classification of or to the class of the element. Water, it belongs to compound. Now what's about oil and air? These are mixers, but there is a difference between them. That oil is an example of heterogeneous mixer and air is an example of homogeneous mixer. Air is also a solution. You may also call it a solution. So these are actually four options and there are four questions behind them. Even more than four can be there. Which of the following is a compound? Alpha. Which of the following is a heterogeneous mixer? Oil. Which of the following is a solution or homogeneous mixer? That is air. And which of the following is an element? That is oxygen. So in this case, we have discussed an example and such kind of MCQs are usually all asked from this. Otherwise, this classification is important to keep in mind. I hope so that the idea of the classification of matter is clear. Next time we will come up with the elements, compounds and their constituent particles. See you. Good luck.